Hello everybody, this is Itsu. I was looking at this cap coil coaxial like new diagrams, and I was wondering if there was any coax being used, or that it's what I think more a tube like coil with a cable inside, which is a kind of coaxial cable. So I was playing around with some copper tubing. I have made two of those coils. They are almost identical. It's 2.5 meters long copper tubing, 6 millimeters. And I've inserted a wire. And this is a high voltage wire, 12 kilovolt inside. And I have made another one identical. It's about 9 turns. This one is counterclockwise, I see. And this one has also a wire in, but this is normal speaker wire split into one. So I will try to make some capacitance measurements now to see what the capacitance is between the inner and the outer side of the wall. My meter without being connected is showing 10 picofarads. So I will hook up now first this one with the high voltage cable and then the other one to see what kind of capacitance this creates. Okay, I've hooked up my meter. One side is to the outside tubing, soldered with a wire, and the other connector is on the inside wire. And we can see that we have almost 200 picofarad with the 10. It's 185 picofarad capacitance between the inner and the outer, so that's not much. We have not much capacitance between those two. Okay, we'll now measure the other one with the other wire. Okay, hooked up this one also across the tubing and the inner wire, and this has more capacitance. This has 256 minus the 10 is about 246 picofarad capacitance between. I will hook up now a high voltage power supply and a spark gap to see what's going to happen, if there is any sparking at all with this low capacitance. Okay, I have here my flyback driven by a MOSFET, and it's powered by this little function generator. I put it on square wave and it's now at 150 kilohertz. And this is my spark gap with magnet on both sides to quench the spark. I have hooked up this coil at the moment only with the tubing, so both sides are connected to the tubing to show you the sparks I get. I will now hook up. And you can see in between that we have a nice spark going. And we can vary the frequency with the function generator. I can also change the spark, the gap. So we can see that this spark gap is working okay, and we are now pulsing this big coil. I will now hook up one lead to the inner conductor, so we make this coaxial capacitance coil. Okay, I've hooked up one side of the spark gap, the plus side, to the inner cable, and the other side is connected still to the copper tubing. But we have almost no spark gap. It's pulsing very slowly now. I can vary the waveform. And also the gap I can decrease, but so I guess it's very hard with this low capacitance to get a nice spark going. I'm not sure how to do it. We should, I guess, increase the capacitance between the outer tubing and the inner coax. I will now switch over to the other coil, which has more capacitance, to see if this goes any better. Okay, I've hooked up now the other coil. That's more capacitance. And we can hear that it's much more sparking, but also irregular. I can vary the frequency with the function generator. But the best spot is somewhere between 155 kHz, which is here. But I get some nasty spikes, I see. I have also my scope somewhere in the vicinity, and we have these kind of spikes going by. But again, it's not easy to have this kind of coils with a capacitor in between sparked at a very rapid rate. Okay, thank you for watching.